And now to news on former Saints safety Darren Sharper. He will remain behind bars in Los Angeles for at least another week. A judge in California says Sharper cannot be extradited to New Orleans to face two rape charges until the district attorney's office here formally charges him with the crimes. The NOPD says Sharper and 26-year-old Erik Nunez raped two women at a Warehouse District condo last fall. But so far, only an arrest warrant has been issued. Sharper has not yet been charged. WDSU reporter Gina Swanson joins us now live in the studio at 10 o'clock with what this means for the case moving forward and what happened at court here in New Orleans with the case against Sharper's alleged accomplice, Erik Nunez. Gina.
Camille, what it means is the DA's office is on the clock. If formal charges aren't filed in a week, he could be released from jail in California. Now, this is prosecutors working this case say they have strong evidence linking Erik Nunez to one of the alleged victims.
Either charge Darren Sharper or he'll no longer be held indefinitely without bond. That's the word from a Los Angeles judge in a hearing Friday afternoon. The judge has set the deadline for the DA's office here to file formal charges by next Thursday.
His life, as he knows it, is going to change drastically.
Sharper and Erik Nunez are accused of drugging and raping two women last year at Sharper's apartment. An arrest warrant from the NOPD indicates they had sex with the women who, quote, had no knowledge and gave no permission for the alleged act. And now there's no clear timeline on how this case will proceed. Nunez is being held here while Sharper is in jail on the other side of the country. But if charged, both will be in a world of trouble. A judge set Nunez's bond at $400,000.
I've seen nothing at this point, and they've had the evidence for 6 months that in any way connects my client to a crime.
I mean, I'm surprised it's not higher. I often think that they overcharge people and also they make the bond much higher than necessary, because we could go to some jurisdictions and the bond would be much lower, but in this jurisdiction, it's probably just about right.
While Nunez's attorneys maintain his innocence, prosecutors said in court they have DNA evidence that links him to one of the victims.
That puts the suspect on the scene with the victim, so there is no way of saying that you were not there or it wasn't you that was there.
Well, basically, if the prosecution have DNA evidence, the defense merely is going to allege it's consensual. That means it's going to be her word against his about what took place.
Of course, the developments here are just one part of the Sharper case. In all, he's accused of raping nine women in investigations that span five states.